Once all are well, once more we take the mill and kill the lone wolves all.
Going to be a grim harvest here this year.
You can find a bucket, sure. Consider it my last offering to a dying race. Your kind has been dismembering and burning mine since time immemorial. I must admit, the smell of charred human flesh is so very enticing.
Thank you. I'll yield to none.
Thank you. Don't worry. I'll keep watch. Don't worry. I'll keep watch.
You sense a blur of movement to your side. Before you can react, there's a blade under your chin and a slim, pale hand upon your weapon. A voice whispers in your ear with a breathy purr.
A guest. How brazen of you to enter without knocking.
The press of the blade encourages you further into the room, then retreats. You turn to face a woman in black ring robes. She's pale and vividly beautiful, wearing a smile that's somewhere between impish and cruel.
Perhaps I'll give you a chance to explain yourself.
Thank you.
You sense a blur of movement to your side. Before you can react, there's a blade under your chin and a slim, pale hand upon your weapon. A voice whispers in your ear with a breathy purr.
A guest.
The press of the blade.
Perhaps I'll give you a chance to explain yourself.
She lowers her weapon and gives you a curious look. Not because of your response, though. She's noticed something.
You're no ordinary traveler, are you? You positively reek of sauce. Are you the one responsible for this mayhem surrounding us? And whoever turned this stretch of cow country into a death-filled valley is likely to be powerful enough to help you. Is that what you thought? You look like someone who wouldn't turn down a good thing when it comes to them. How about a little deal? You help us, and I'll show you how to make true use of sauce.
She gestures to where a young magister is propped up on a cot in the corner. He's ashen and dazed, his shoulder bound in layers of crimson-soaked wound dressings.
This is Mahali. We absconded together. I from the Black Ring and he from the Magisters. We fell for each other while I was his prisoner. Love will set you free. Mahali put himself at great risk to free me from Magister captivity. We made it clear, but he picked up quite a nasty wound. We found refuge in this charming hamlet. But then, well, I'm sure you saw for yourself. The landscape tore itself open, Voidwoken appeared, and a shroud of decay fell over us. It's preventing Mahali's wounds from healing. So, now we must escape this place, or else remove the decaying shroud so Mahali can heal. Help us, and I'll help you. Thank you. Please, clear the way so that we can head south in the direction of the coast. The north is too dangerous. It crawls with Voidwoken. Once you've helped Mahali and I pass freely, once we're truly clear, I'll give you what you want.
Her eyes speak volumes.
All that you want. Good. Now listen closely. Clear anything that will impede Mahali. Flames, those accursed fumes, anything. Come back here when there's a safe route, and we will follow you.
Don't worry. I'll keep you. Well now, how's my favorite god woken?
If Anne smiles...
This is madness! I'm having flashbacks from the Great War! The Ganglelegs have gone nuts for good this time! They're destroying the place for reasons too stupid to know. The Black Ring, of course. At least they're honest about how wicked they are.
Thank you.
another monstrosity, as if Rivalon didn't have enough already.
Doesn't it?
Thank you.
You sense a blur
again.
The press of
perhaps I'll give you.
She lowers her weapon, and
you're no ordinary traveler, are you? You positively reek of sauce. Are you the one responsible for this mayhem surrounding us? And whoever you look like.
She just.
This is Mahali, but then. So. Now we must thank you. Once you've helped.
Her eye.
All that you want. Wise, perhaps. Don't worry. I'll keep watch.
What the hell is that thing?
Prepare yourself.